Many people are familiar with Google Earth, and environmental groups are using it today to take people all around the world virtually to places on the planet that are under threat. The Suruwi tribe is also using Google Earth as a tool based on the training the Google Earth Outreach team did in 2008 when we went down to the Suruwi territory in the Amazon. We taught them how to put their cultural map information on Google Earth and share their culture with the world. However, now the Suruwi want to go beyond this. And that's where Google Earth Engine comes in.
Para nossa visão indígena, floresta é único, uma das papel que pode trazer a clima normal. Estamos trabalhando com o projeto Carbono Suruwi, né? Então, oferecer ao mercado o serviço que a floresta tem para diminuir o gás de estufa.
What you need for what Chief Almir wants is a living, breathing, daily update of the planet. Google Earth was not designed for that. That's what we're building with Google Earth Engine. With Google Earth Engine, we, Google, are focusing on what we do best, which is organizing this information and making it available in a way that's never been possible before because of the scale of the data and the scale of the computational resources required.
The Suruwi Red Carbon Project is one of the most advanced, or is the most advanced in the Amazon today. We're inserting Android handheld devices or telephones into the data collection process for carbon measurement. Because if you're saying you're going to reduce deforestation and in that way reduce carbon emissions into the atmosphere, you need to be able to measure or show how much carbon you're really preventing from going into the atmosphere.
Para medir uma árvore, você tem que tamanho de árvore que está sendo calculado o carbono lá, né? Então, você vai seguindo o formulário que está dentro do equipamento.
This is the first project really where the Indians themselves are the ones measuring the carbon and being taught how to do it, and they're using this technology. And so the technology allows them to become the carbon monitors.
Você pode usar também para denúncias, né? Se você analisar uma ameaça à floresta, né? Você pode também denunciar isso.
Today, if you want to monitor deforestation in the Amazon, it takes weeks to run the analysis. By the time you've done that, the illegal activities are long gone. With Google Earth Engine, you can build a real-time alerting system based on images that are taken that show what the state of the forest was last week, what is it this week. When you see a suspicious change, Chief Almir and the Suruwi will be notified. They will go on the ground with the Google Android smartphones and investigate. They will take photographs and videos. They will document what's happening and who's doing it. That will then get uploaded back into Earth Engine for anyone around the world to see the reality of what's happened and then begin to support a law enforcement proceeding.
Como tecnologia, como equipamento Google, pode ser importante para construir um futuro melhor, um futuro que tenha consciência. Como é que as pessoas estão construindo solução para aqueles, mas isoladamente, mas precisamos juntar, né? Precisamos pensar em um mundo como fosse nosso, de todo mundo, que é, né?
And what's important now is to use the power of the internet to bring together all the voices that can participate in a dialogue toward constructive solutions for the planet. That's what we're building with Earth Engine, and we're putting it in the hands of the world. It's going to be a great adventure.